In this video, we'll recreate the Earth's moon using three textures. We'll also look at how to solve a common issue with textures on UV spheres. First, download both the color texture and the height map of the moon surface from NASA's website. There are several download options for each. The higher resolution is especially important for the height map. You may want to rename these files to avoid confusion later. In Blender, add a UV sphere. By default, Generate UVs is enabled, so there's no need to UV unwrap the sphere yourself. Right-click and choose Shade Smooth. Add a subdivision modifier and a displacement modifier to the sphere. As coordinates, choose UV. Load the height map as the displacement texture. Set its color space to non-color. You may have to tweak the displacement strength value. Increase the amount of subdivisions to squeeze more detail out of the height map. Switch to Material Preview in the 3D viewport. In the shader editor, create a material for the sphere and add the color texture to it. It looks pretty cool, but there is an issue that you'll notice when you look closer at the poles of the sphere. When using an equirectangular texture on a UV sphere, you will see this ugly pinching of the texture at the poles. This wouldn't be an issue with a quad sphere. Unfortunately, equirectangular textures are meant to be used on a UV sphere. Fortunately, there's a simple solution. Instead of UV texture coordinates, set it to generated instead. Then set texture interpolation to smart and projection method to sphere. Unfortunately, this means the mapping of the displacement map and the color map are no longer the same. So remove the displacement modifier and add the height map with a displacement node instead. Set it to also use smart interpolation and sphere projection with generated mapping. In the material settings, set displacement to displacement only or displacement and bump. Now you can see the displacement in the cycle's rendered preview. As you can see, the pole pinching issue is greatly reduced.